सो कैनन फॉर वर्बल प्लेन एंड नोटेशनल प्लेन ओनली थ्री कैनन्स वर लेफ्ट मीन्स टू प्लेन्स कैनन्स वर लेफ्ट वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड अवर आइडिया प्लेन कैनन्स एंड यू हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट हाउ मेनी कैनन्स आर देयर इन द आइडिया प्लेन ओके सो दैट यू हैव टू लर्न इट बिकॉज वी हैव शेयर द टेक्स्ट एंड द अदर मटीरियल विथ यू ऑन द गूगल क्लासरूम So here we will learn that what are the various canons for verbal plane. You may be knowing that in idea plane we are just seeing the how the concept should be generated, okay, or how the concept should be evolved, and based on that concept we are logically thinking, and based on that we are making the groups in the idea planes. Means what will be the subject. Then here for the verbal plane. Whatever ideas we have in our mind, that we have to write it. Okay, so it is very simple. It is the canon for terminology. Means how we can choose the terms for the specific concept, or whatever concepts are there in the subject. So how we are choosing the terms. So that is we have to learn here the canon for terminology. So after reading this, means after listening this lecture, you will have the acquaintance with the work in the idea plane. Means what is the idea plane? You will learn. Verbal plane you will learn because we have seen the idea plane. Then you will understand the importance of using the standard terminology for scientific communication and in making the classification system also. So how we can use the terms for the scientific communication or for writing the scientific communication, and how we can use these terms for our classification system also. Okay, and verbal plane and the canon for terminology is the same. So here that's why I have given the two parts here. Canon for verbal plane, all the terms which we are using for classification, that will all come in the verbal plane. And we will also see the canon for notational plane. So today we are trying to see the verbal plane canons, and I hope in one class it will be okay, or it will be completed. So what is verbal plane? We know that whatever the idea plane concept we have created, based on the idea plane, the means we have to express our ideas with the help of the language. So language, if we are not using our language or our specific name for the specific subject, then how we can tell that this is the subject, okay, or this is the concept. So an idea without a name cannot be conveyed properly. So for this we have to use the verbal plane. So if idea plane is the message, in idea plane we are seeing that the concept should be created or message should be generated. Okay, so whatever message we have generated or concept we have generated, that we have to express in the linguistic way, or verbal plane is its linguistic expression. So verbal plane is nothing, whatever terms we are providing or terminology we are providing, that we have to give in the verbal plane. Okay, and in classification also, whose mic is on? Please off your mic. I think Param, okay, your mic is on. Please off your mic. Okay, thank you. So in the idea plane, whatever the ideas are generated, that idea should be expressed in the linguistic way. So language play an important role for in the verbal plane, and in this phase also, in the verbal plane or in the classification work, we have to give the standard terms, okay, and that is called the hookah names also, to the concept arranged in an array, chain, filatory sequence in the idea plane. So whatever in the idea plane we have seen, that how we have to develop the chain, how we have to develop the array, or how we have to give the filatory sequence also, and what will be the characteristics, then succession of characteristics. So all these five inherent group in the idea plane we have seen. But whatever characteristics we are choosing it, so here in the idea plane, based on the characteristics we are providing, means we are making a different group. So when you are making the groups, then you have to use the technical term. Okay, like for example, library science, then library science the technical term is library classification, library cataloging, then thesaurus. So like this, you have to use the standard term. Otherwise, it may be difficult to categorized all the concepts. So for that, you have to use the verbal, in verbal plane, you have to see that how the standard terms can be used. Okay. So whatever ideas are in our mind that we are expressing or we are communicating with the specific name. So in this phase, we dress the airy ideas in the proper and visible garment of the language of standard terms to handle them. Okay, and it is also important as idea needs some media of expression and the communication. So whatever ideas we have generated, that idea should be expressed, that idea should be communicated. Then only it will give some message, okay, or it will be converted into the information. So for this, all this idea in the proper words, if we are expressing, and if it is a universal, then the people will understand easily. Okay, no idea can be communicated by the lingual means without apt words. So in science, in technology, or in humanities, or in any subject, we all the terms means technical terms are there. So that we have to use it. It may be a library science, it may be a political science, it may be a history. So every subject has its technical term. So that we have to use it in the verbal plane. Okay. So in overall, you can say that in the verbal plane, whatever ideas has been generated in the idea plane, that has to be represented by the specific language. And that language, we should not use the general language, but it should be the technical language of the subject. Okay. So whatever classes we have created, for example, suppose we have created a different classes here. Okay. It may be the array, or it may be in the form of chain, we have created a different classes. So that should be expressed here. Suppose you can write library science. Then again, in library science, whatever terms are related with that library science, that is technical term, you have to write it. Okay. So in the verbal plane, these groups or ideas can be represented with the help of language. Then the natural language. So before understanding the technical language, we have to see the natural language. So natural language means it is a whatever thoughts we have created that we are expressing in the natural language. So it and also for social and academic and technical and research communication, we are using it. Okay, in some way. But without it, there could be no civilization, no progress, perhaps no art or science also. So we have to use the, sometime we have to use this language also. So without language, we are nothing. Okay, whatever ideas we have created, that has to be expressed by the language. So without a developed language, we may not be able to think even. And it is the human species which has developed a sophisticated communication system. So if we are not using any language, then we will be considered as a animal living also. Okay, so without language, we can't live, we can't express it. So language is important in the verbal plane. And if we are using the natural language, that is the language we are using it, natural language means day-to-day language, okay, which we are using it in our particular things. So here there is a paradox of the natural languages, whatever languages we are using. Sometime it is the homonym, sometime it is the synonym. So let us see what is synonym. Synonym is that is usually it has many words for a single concept. Okay, like for example, wage, pay, salary means the same things, but there are different words for the same concept. So that is called as a synonym. So everybody is knowing that what is synonym, because you may be using the dictionary also. So many linguistic and philosophers, they are say that we should not give, means we may not be providing a proper synonym. So that sometimes the synonym may be the absolute also. Means it may be the out of date also. So here we have to use some type of, in classification system, we have to use some that we can say class numbers, okay, or any the notational language, okay. So natural language, to overcome with the natural language, we have to use the notation. But here in the verbal plane, we are using the language. Based on the language only, we can express the ideas. Then homonym. Homonym, the meaning is clear. It is a means one word may be there, but more than two or three meanings may be there for one word. Okay. So here we may be confused that how to use this particular word for the specific terms. Okay. So here the Ranganathan finds the five meaning of the word like classification. So here the classification, if we are using the classification for arranging the books in the library, then we will solve all these problems of homonym and synonym. So for this, for expressing the idea, we have to use the language. There is no doubt. But if we are using the same language, then it may be difficult to arrange the books. So that's why we are using it in the notation form. So notation or any class numbers, we are using it. It may be a mixed notation or it may be the pure notation. So when we see the part of notational plane canons, then we can also go into the depth of that. So for this, what we are using it like vocabulary control. So in science, it is very common, the vocabulary control. Vocabulary control will give you the idea what terms, specific terms, we have to use it for the specific concept. Okay. And then these standard terms, vocabulary control also give you the standard term. All the standardized terminology will use for the vocabulary control. So for library science also, many thesaurus, vocabulary control, you may be heard about the thesaurus. So thesaurus is nothing but it will give you the, like for example, one term is there. So what will be the broader term, what will be the narrower term for that particular concept, it will give you the idea. And what will be the standard vocabulary also, that will give the idea. So for that also, we have to use, we have to take the help if you want to develop the classification scheme like DDC or any other classification scheme, then you have to use the standard terms for expressing that particular idea, for expressing that particular subject. So each subject, it may be a science, social science, or the technology, all the subject are having their own standard terminology. So for that also, we can use these thesaurus or the control, vocabulary control, we can say. So Ranganathan has given the five views, means views on for this, how to overcome with this natural language. So delimit the vagueness of the word and eliminate ambiguity. So if we are using, sometime we are using the wage, sometime we are using these salary. Sometime we are using it other words. So the meaning is same, like so synonyms we are using or antonyms we are using. But here the Ranganathan has given the idea that we have to eliminate the ambiguity, means we should not be confused about how, what type of words we have to use in the library classification. Okay. Then establish an agreed standard terminology free from homonyms and free from synonyms for each subject field. So whatever the subject field, like library science or any other subject field, every subject is having their own vocabulary or thesaurus. So that we have to use it when we are using this library classification scheme. Then lay down methodology to coin new terms when new ideas come into being, or an old term has to be replaced. So when any new term is coming in the field of any subject, so that we have to use it, otherwise that particular term may be obsolete. So we have to also take care in library classification, while designing a library classification scheme, you have to take care about all these terms, that terminology should be updated, and terminology should be universally accepted. So like this, many canons are there in this verbal plane. We can see it later. So canon for verbal plane are having the different type of verbal plane will decide the type of terminology to be used in the scheme of classification, because we have seen what is the problem of the natural language. So natural language may be imperfect, and there are many vagueness in the meaning of the natural language, and we cannot use whatever day-to-day conversation we are using the language, we cannot use to express the specific subject or any technical term. So for this, whatever the limitation of natural language is there, we have to overcome all these limitations, and then we have to use the notational language or whatever the language we are using in the classification. So we have seen that homonyms and synonym concept, and the classifier are concerned with the application of the schemes, and that they may find this useful in interpreting the terms in the schedule at the time of classifying documents. So when the classifier also classify the books or giving any class number to the books, so that time also classifier has to decide that what term has been used, whatever terms are there in the title. So we have to see the title, and we have to see that what terms are very exact term. And based on that keyword, based on that term, he will search for classifying the books, or he will search for the what type of documents are in the main classes. Okay, so that he has to take care, and even the classificationist has also take care. All the terms should be technical term they are using in the classification scheme. So this verbal plane is having four canons, and again I think one canon is also added here. I have not taken that particular canon. Canon of context is one, then canon of enumeration is second, canon of currency is then, and then canon of reticence is there. Okay, so let us see all these canons in detail. So first, the canon of context. So this canon of context is saying that whatever terms we are using in the verbal plane, that term should be used in that particular context. Okay. I will read it first. It lays down that the term in the classification schedule be written or read in the context of the upper class. For example, here instead of writing single salt, double salt, then complex salt, we should write salt, single, double, and complex. Okay, so here whatever context is there, based on that context you can use the term. So here, for example, here single salt is there, double salt is there, complex salt is there. So instead of using this term, you can use this salt, single, double, and complex in classification scheme, while making the classification scheme. Okay, and similarly in psychology, under the person facet, child and female or male are using, means this such type of terms or such type of verbal language we are using it. Okay, so here we have to see that instead of using this one, child psychology, you can use it. Male psychology, female psychology, you can use it. Otherwise, in classification, you will get the idea that first psychology will be written. Then, under that, first, where is notation? First, here they will write the psychology. Okay, and then under this, they will write child psychology, means child only. So the meaning is clear. Once you see the DDC, then you can understand this concept. So here the first psychology subject will be there, and then within that, under this psychology, child will be there, female will be there. So that it can be understood that it is the child psychology, it is the female psychology, it is the male psychology. So that is the concept. So canon of context is saying that whatever terms we are using, it should be in the particular context. Okay, otherwise if we are not using the terms properly, then the terms will be misunderstood by the classifier or even the users also. Okay, so for that, whatever terms we are using, it should be used in that particular context. Then canon of enumeration is there. So canon of enumeration is saying that whatever concepts are there, for example, if this is the concept, then all concepts should be enumerated. If this is the classes, then this should be enumerated, this also should be enumerated, this also should be enumerated, and the whatever the array we have created in the idea plane, all should be represented by the verbal term, means by the terminology. Okay, so their connotations vary from time to time, even from classification system to classification system. For example, dynamic is considered, it is a part of mathematics by some, and it is also the physics by others. So dynamic concept, it is a part of mathematics also, and dynamic concept, it is a part of physics also. So as documentation is a part of library science in Kolon classification, while in the universal means UDC scheme is also there like DDC, it is an independent classes. So instead of writing their documentation, means the documentation is coming library science, but in some classification scheme, they are considering different subject, like in UDC, they have considered in the different subject. But here, what canon of enumeration is saying, whatever classes we have created in the idea plane, so all classes should be enumerated, okay? And it should, if we are not enumerated, so it may be enumerated in the DDC. It is not expected that all the other schemes also enumerated in the same way, okay? So, but for this also, you have to take care that whenever you enumerate the concept, any concept, it may be this one or this one or this one. So that's why standard terminology, we have to use it so that whenever in the specific library classification scheme, suppose DDC is using documentation, but some other classification scheme is using documentation services or other type of concept for documentation, then that the user may confused also, okay? So, or the classifier will also confuse. So for that, you have to see that whatever the canon of enumeration, according to the enumeration, whatever concepts in the idea plane has been created, that has to be represented by the proper term, okay? Or we should not, should not leave any concept to give the enumeration, to give the verbal plane or to give any the terms. So for that, canon of enumeration is saying whatever has been developed in the idea plane, all concept, all heading should be enumerated. Whatever it may be, the list, it may be any concept, that you have to take care for enumerating the concept. Then canon of currency. Canon of currency, it is saying that, I will take your attendance, otherwise. Okay, then canon of currency. So canon of currency is saying whichever is the terms which are in the current use, okay? So we have to use that current terms only. Otherwise, if we are using the older term, then user may be knowing about the older terms, but for the next edition, you have to replace the terms. Okay. So whatever the current terms are there in the specific subject, that you have to use it. Otherwise, it may be difficult to revise the particular scheme. So we have to use the current term. So in the classification system, always update its terminology using the current term with their explicit connotations. And new addition of classification system not only include new knowledge, but also use the current terminology. For example, if the library and information science concept, for example, means suppose previously it was documentation documentation. Okay, then after that information is added. After that means only library science we are saying it. Okay, previously, but now the information is added in this. So we have to means whenever you develop the DDC or any classification scheme, we have to add the new concept. Like not only we have to write library science, but instead of library science, you can use library and information science. Okay, so library science, previously it was said that library science, but now we are we have developed the concept, means they have developed the terminology library and information science. So in classification scheme also, that terms you have to use it. Okay, then home science has become the home management also. Okay, so instead of home science, you can write home management while developing the classification scheme. So it will not only help in efficient information retrieval, but also our classification system respectable in the eye of the scholars and the subject specialist. So at least those who are developing the classification scheme, that is called as a classificationist, okay, so they will show that yes, they are updated. Even the subject specific as any expert in that particular subject is using classification scheme, then they should also know, yes, this particular term is now new and they are using in our classification system. So canon of currency is saying whatever current terms are there, we have to use that current terms while designing our classification scheme. Okay, then canon of reticence. Canon of reticence, it means that the term that we use in the schedule of classification should neither be judgmental nor critical. Okay, yani koi aisa terms jisse ki kisi ko harm ho ya fir jisse ki kisi ko theek na lage, aise terms we should not use it. Okay, that is canon of reticence. So for example, DDC ke jo pehle wale jo editions the, usme Humbugs for parapsychologist उसको कहा जाता था. In DDC the new term Negroes was replaced by black. Okay, पहले black word use किया जाता था और ultimately the African Americans we are saying it. Okay, so that term we have to use it. For example, previously also we have taken this example in some of the canons, reticence. So ऐसा word use नहीं करना चाहिए कि जो कि किसी particular category को represent करता हो और किसी particular व्यक्ति को जिससे hurt हो. Okay, so ऐसे terms we should not use for the library classification scheme. And classification scheme has to be sensitive to all sort of the feelings of the community at large, and hence classification system should use a current and neutral terms. Okay, जैसे for example author को define करना है तो author को define करते वक्त suppose आप excellent, outstanding और poor आपने ये word use किया, so means poor author क्या होता है, means ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता है, poor will also harm. Okay, so instead of poor you can use the other. So canon of reticence is saying whatever terms we are using in the verbal plane, that should not be harmful to any others and should not be critical for any person. I think time will be running out, but don't rejoin it, okay, because we have the exams. Then canon of consistency. Okay, so canon of consistency, another requirement is that consistency in terms of terminology, which Dr. Ranganathan have seems to have omitted. Canon of consistency ye directly usko bahut zyada apply nahi kar sakte hain, because hum bolte hain ki canon of currency, so to dono ko conflict karne ki baat aati hai. Canon of currency mein hum log bol rahe hain ki jab bhi naya terms aayega to classification scheme mein usko use kiya jaye, but consistency kab follow ki ja sakti hai ki jab tak ki classification ke liye koi, जब तक कि वो सब्जेक्ट के लिए कोई नया टर्म नहीं आ जाता है, तब तक वो कंसिस्टेंटली वही वर्ड हमको यूज करना चाहिए. सो दैट इज कैनन ऑफ कंसिस्टेंसी. तो दोनों कैनन ऑफ करेंसी यानी करंट टर्म यूज करना चाहिए, बट जब तक कि कोई नया टर्म्स वो पर्टिकुलर कंसेप्ट के लिए नहीं आता है तब तक हमको कंसिस्टेंटली वही टर्म्स यूज करना चाहिए, बार बार उसको चेंजेस करने की आवश्यकता नहीं है. सो इन वर्बल प्लेन वी असाइन स्टैंडर्ड टर्म्स टू द कंसेप्ट इन द आइडिया प्लेन एंड वर्बल प्लेन गिव्स कॉन्क्रीट नेम टू द एरी कंसेप्ट ऑफ द आइडिया प्लेन बाय क्लोथिंग देम इन द स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड टर्म. सो वर्बल प्लेन में क्या किया जाता है कि स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड टर्म्स को यूज करके क्लासिफिकेशन स्कीम में उसको बताया जाता है. ओके. एंड इंडेक्सिंग लैंग्वेज और इंफॉर्मेशन रिट्रेवल के लिए जो लैंग्वेज लगती है वो टेक्निकल टर्म को यूज करने के बाद ही उसको रिट्राइव कर सकते हैं. और ये काम कौन करता है? कंट्रोल वोकैबुलरी जो इंफॉर्मेशन रिट्रेवल के लिए यूज की जाती है. ओके. सो कैनन ऑफ वर्बल प्लेन इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट. इसमें इतने ही कैनन थे, 5 ही कैनन्स थे उसमें. सो वो आप, मैं आपको टेक्स्ट जो है वो शेयर कर देती हूँ, देन यू कैन रीड द टेक्स्ट ऑल्सो एंड आई विल शेयर दिस PPT ऑल्सो. सो आई थिंक टुमारो वी कैन टेक इट द कैनन ऑफ नोटेशनल प्लेन, देन अवर चैप्टर ऑफ कैनन्स फॉर आइडिया प्लेन, वर्बल प्लेन एंड नोटेशनल प्लेन विल बी ओवर. ओके. सो हियर आई विल फॉर टूडे दिस मच इज सफिशेंट एंड आई विल जस्ट स्टॉप शेयरिंग एंड आई विल टेक यूर अटेंडेंस वंस. Okay, now the meeting will be running out for 2 minutes. It will be leave. It will be over, I think. So you just read today's canon, canon of notational plane. Okay, it is very means canon of verbal plane. And tomorrow we will see the canon of notational plane also. And on 8th, I may not be take your class because I am having the other assignment. If you want to join for the same lecture which I am having for the another college, I will share the link with you and then you can also join. That lecture will be on the digital library and the e-resources. Okay, so you can also join that lecture. I will share tomorrow that particular link, or otherwise I will see if it is now, then tomorrow I will share that particular link. Okay. So thank you for joining this class and we are not continuing it. So tomorrow we will take that canon for notational plane. So till then, keep learning and keep reading the text which we are already sharing on the Google Classroom. And I think everybody is on now Google Classroom. आपको आपके means text मिल रहा है ना? बाकी जो भी notification we are posting, that you are getting it or not? सो वो टेक्स्ट आप पढ़िए, जब भी डिफिकल्टी है कुछ तो आप यानी एग्जामिनेशन के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से भी पढ़िए, क्योंकि आपके एग्जाम मीन्स कभी भी आ सकती है. इसलिए जो जितना पोर्शन होते जाता है उसको आप रीड करना स्टार्ट कर दीजिए. अभी तक तो कोई पैटर्न डिसाइडेड नहीं है आपके एग्जाम का, बट इट मे बी द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑल्सो और इट मे बी द डिस्क्रिप्टिव ऑल्सो. इट डिपेंड्स कि अभी कोरोना का और क्या स्टेटस है. ओके. सो बी सेफ एट योर होम. ओके. जस्ट आई एम लीविंग द मीटिंग. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू.